Hello, so this is yoga poses that help with menstrual pain. Let's talk about yoga for menstrual cramps. Using yoga for menstrual cramps is an effective pain relief strategy. First, think about the areas of your body that typically experience pain from cramping, your belly, your pelvis, hips, and lower back. These areas can be targeted for pain relief through certain yoga poses. Additionally, the emotional support of PMS and menstruation can help be reduced by yoga, so it can be more than treat period, so it can do more than treat period. There are several different schools of yoga out there and countless positions and adaptations. It can be a little overwhelming and start from scratch. Whether you have a significant amount of yoga experience or none at all, we want to be able to help you use yoga to treat your menstrual cramps. Here are a few specific poses for menstrual cramps. We encourage you to give these a try. So, yoga position number one is an adapted child pose. Child pose is one of the most familiar yoga poses, even to less experienced practitioners or those who are quite new to yoga practice. These poses target menstrual pain that is primarily found in the back. For child pose, start with your knees on the floor. We'll call this the adapted child pose because you want to widen your knees further apart than you typically would for this pose to aid in pain relief. Fold forward, extend your arms, and bend down as far as you can comfortably go. If possible, lean your forehead on the mat in front of you for five slow diaphragmic breaths. Diaphragm and breathe, or breaths use your belly rather than your chest. You can also turn your head from one side to the other, slowly counting five breaths before turning to the other side. You're going to want to relax your hips and slowly stretch those lower back muscles. So yoga position number two is the cat and the cow. Cat-cow is a two-part pose that will target just not just the back, but also your abdominal muscles. Start with the cow pose. On your hands and knees, check to make sure your hands are aligned with your shoulders. Your knees should be aligned with your hips. Gently stretch your back, your head upwards, gazing towards the sky as you breathe. At the same time, raise your tailbone towards the sky and drop your belly down towards the ground. Now it is time to move to the cat pose. Breathe normally for a few breaths, then after a deep inhalation, breathe out slowly, curl your back, your head and your tailbone should stretch towards the ground. The gentle arc of your spine will warm your back muscles as well as stretch to tone your abdominals. So exhale in the cat pose and inhale on the cat. Repeat 5 to 10 times to help relieve your pain. Yoga position number three is the reclining twist. Your lower back and lower belly will both benefit from the reclining twist pose. So, first, lie on the floor, flat on your back, bend your left knee, and then lower to the right side. Look at your left and reach your arms out wide. Your palms flat against the ground. You will want to stay here for five or more breaths. Extend your left leg back to the ground and repeat the pose with your right leg bending to the right. This pose should relax your back, hips, and shoulders. Repeat 5 to 10 times for each side. So yoga position number four is the pigeon pose. So the pigeon pose will help you help your hips feel more relaxed as they carry the stress and menstrual cramps. The pigeon pose will help stretch and relieve the pain felt in your hips. First, position yourself in the upright sitting position. Bend your right knee and extend your left leg behind you. Arch your back as you help place your hands on your hips. A more intense stretch can be achieved if you reach your arms over your head and bring your hands together. Position yourself on all fours. Bring your right knee forward towards your right wrist and extend your right ankle so it is in line with your left hip. Slowly slide your leg back and balance. And depending on your flexibility, you may need to keep your hands positioned on the ground. As your leg extends, you will feel a stretching of your left hip, and you will also feel stretching along the right side, but it shouldn't be painful. If it is painful, you may need to modify the pose. Hold your position for several breaths before returning to the center and repeating the pose with your left. So then finally, the corpse pose, which is probably the easiest of all. This position is a frequent ending pose for yoga courses, and it can be especially useful in the practice of mindfulness to overcome menstrual pain. This one is less about stretching your body and more about relaxing and focusing your mind. Corpse pose is called is also called the Savasana. Lie flat on your back and then rest your palms in your hands facing up. Slowly relax your body, starting with the top of your head, then your neck, your shoulders, your spine, your arms and legs, your thighs, your calves, your ankles, and then finally your feet. So that's it for this video. Thank you for listening.